From BYU Broadcasting's performance studio, this is Highway 89.
Hello and welcome to Highway 89. I'm Mark Waite and I'm about to take you on a little journey. Picture in your mind the vast expanse of the Alaskan landscape. There aren't many people, definitely more animals than people. It's chilly, even in the summer, and the days can either last all day or all night. Now imagine driving a bus full of tourists across that terrain, and you have a sense of what led the creation of Michael Barrow and the Tourists, today's guests on Highway 89. The band consists of the aforementioned Michael Barrow, playing vocals and lead guitar. Alessandro Improta is the bassist. Reed Perkins, drums. Mark Lanham, lead guitar. And Zach Collier, keyboard. We're going to talk more about that Alaskan adventure later. But first, let's hear Sing Me Something New.
Sing me something new. You know that I will listen, but the burden of existence will take its toll on you. But you'll never have to be alone, 'cause we are coming home. We are coming home. Look up at the sky, the stars are all appearing. Your wounds will all be healing, even as you say goodbye to the only place you know. And we are coming home. We are coming home. And my child, I can't believe how much you've grown. Whoa. Whoa, 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 whoa.
Sing Me Something New, that's Michael Barrow and the Tourists here on Highway 89. And we're going to have a little conversation now with this Michael Barrow fellow who used to drive a tourist bus around Alaska. Michael, tell us all you know about Alaska.
So Alaska is...
Big.
Is big. It is big. Juneau's not very big. There are about 30,000 people that live there, so like smaller than BYU. But I worked 2 summers there driving a tour bus, and it was just...
Are you from there?
The connection? My friend was like, hey, you should drive tour buses in Alaska. And I was like, cool. And me and all my roommates signed up, and then last minute they all bailed, and I went by myself to Alaska. And it was a really cool experience. I got to kind of do some self-discovery. I got a lot of inspiration. I wrote a lot of music.
Is this the people coming off of cruise ships hopping on your bus?
Exactly.
And where are you taking
them? We would park right at the dock. They would hop on our bus, and we'd drive them. The most popular place we would usually go to was the Mendenhall Glacier, because you could just see it right there from the road, and they could go around and take little walking tours and things like that. But we'd do that. We'd go whale watching, zip lining, things like that.
Did you ever get so involved while working in writing music and conceptualizing and your creative process that you actually got everybody back to their cruise ship late and it left without them?
I always made sure to make sure to get back on time. to get back on time.
So one of the songs in this next block coming up, Hey, 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 I hear that's got a history to it.
Yeah, I wrote that one actually even before my first summer in Alaska. This was a long time ago. I had been going through some stuff, and I decided I would get it all down on a page, and I would really just express how I was feeling, and I was pretty happy with how it turned out. So I decided to go enter in a songwriting competition, because I had made this thing that came straight from my soul into a song. Right?
This is my baby. Is this a cute baby?
It's a sad baby, but it's a cute baby. And I took it.
But that's risky, asking other people, hey, is my baby a cute baby?
Exactly. And the answer apparently was no. It was not a cute baby. So I took it to the songwriting competition, and I got last place. I'd lost. And that was kind of disheartening.
Now, wait a minute. There was a competition where they said, oh, by the way, you're last place?
Yeah, so
you usually just say, here's 1, 2, and 3, and
right.
Then all the rest of you can just kind of wonder who's better and who's not better.
Yeah,
said, Michael Barrow, you're number 27.
Pretty
out
much.
Of 27.
Yeah, so there were actually only 6 of us, but everyone would sing their first song, and then they cut one person, and then the next 5 sing their second song, and I was cut first. I was sad, because apparently my baby was ugly.
And yet,
we eventually recorded it. I recorded it here with my band. And after a while, it kind of blew up in Taiwan. It was really cool. It made it on a Spotify playlist that was curated over there. And it's now...
Hey,
is it
once
still
you've
on
hit in Taiwan,
song?
There's nowhere to go
yeah.
after you've hit in Taiwan.
Except Taiwan. We need to go there. But yeah, so that was after the initial kind of letdown and heartbreak of my ugly baby. It was nice that the Taiwanese think it is cute.
Excellent. Well, let's hear that Hey, Hey, Hey with a couple of other songs. Mm-hmm. Let's go ahead and get back into Sweet Honey, and then we're going to hear that Hey, Hey, Hey. And What Is It For? Will be the third song in this block. We're listening to Michael Barrow and the Tourists on Highway 89, BYU Radio.
There's a girl that I've been keeping my eye on. She's got a way of getting under my skin. And every time I feel like I'm getting closer, ooh, she's just not letting me in. But I need that sweet honey, just a little taste on my tongue. Give me that sweet honey, I wanna be with you, baby, even if I get stung. There's a girl that I've been calling up lately. Think I like her more than I would admit. But every time I'm trying to tell her, ooh, she's just not taking the hint. but I need that sweet honey. Oh, little taste on my tongue, yeah, give me that sweet honey. Wanna be with you, baby, even if I get stung. Now, baby, you're not gonna believe it. Now I've needed your sweetness since day one. Now, honey, can't keep me dreaming about what you're thinking for too much longer. Sweet. You're the one that taught me words are a living thing. You feel it now. Your heart's a wild creature, but time has clipped its wings. Break the walls. This prison is a place of your design. Watch it fall. Lift your voice and listen. The wind will bring you mine. A shout of hallelujah on my tongue. But a shout into the void can't be heard by anyone. I don't want this to be just another memory. Hey. Hey, hey. Listen close to what it has to say. Fading light. The world that we pretend to know ends every single day. Hasten steps. Take you where you know you long to be. Nothing else can matter. You're all that I can see. A breath of hallelujah in my lungs. But a breath without a word can't be heard by anyone. The only thing I know is I don't want you to go. Hey, hey. I can't see like I used to. My eyelids are shut. And I'm searching for something, but I don't know what. But I'll try to reach it. But everything's dark. I put it together and it falls apart. I can't tell if I'm tired or even awake, or if I've been given enough rules to know which to break. 'Cause I can't see like I used to. No, not anymore. And if my eyes aren't for seeing, then what are they for? I can't feel like I used to. No, everything's numb. Now could you explain to me just what you've done? 'Cause I'm blind and I'm broken, but somehow alive. And I've come to the edge, can't make myself dive. But I've been a witness, and I've seen enough proof to know when you're lying to me, when you're telling the truth. 'Cause I can't feel like if my heart's not fulfilling, then what is it for? I used to. No, not anymore. And if my heart's not for feeling, then what is it for? If my heart's not for feeling, then what is it for?
Michael Barrow and the Tourists on Highway 89. We've just heard a block of songs, Sweet Honey, Hey, 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 and What Is It For? We're going to now talk to the bassist, Alessandro Improta. Alessandro, are you Italian or something?
Yeah, yeah. My dad was born in Naples, Italy.
Napoli.
Yeah.
And so you're a pizza snob?
Yeah, snob isn't the word I like to use, but yeah.
Pretty a connoisseur.
Much. Yeah, sure. We can go with that.
But here's the deal with Neapolitan pizza.
You can't find it here. That's the deal.
No,
it.
They've got it. I've had it. The thing is, it's like it. A crust with heart. It's like barely any kind of sauce and then just a few little splotches of cheese. Didn't the Americans take that and take it to a higher level by actually putting more sauce and more cheese and some pepperoni
Look,
on
it? Look, I don't want to, like,
Let's get
talk
derailed.
Bad about the Americans here, but...
Go ahead. You're amongst friends.
Americans did exactly what they do with everything else. They took something good and they took it to excess. So it's good. It's good. It's great. I love it. I just had pizza today.
It's two different things, though.
Yeah, it's apples and oranges.
I've never pizza. Had apples or oranges on my pizza. So
and hopefully not pineapple either.
Michael, Hawaiian pizza. I love Hawaii. Love pizza. They don't work together. So Michael got going while he was in Alaska. We've heard about that. But you, the Tourists, did you exist before then, or did you merely spring from his imagination like some sort of sci-fi story?
A little bit of both, I guess. Zach Reed and I have been doing music together for about 5 years now. And so we knew each other.
Under a different name?
Yeah, we've...
You weren't Michael Barrow and the Tourists before Michael joined?
No, nor were we just the Tourists.
And you went looking everywhere for a musician named Michael Barrow just to fit?
No, we've just done a whole lot of different things together over the past few years, and... Zach had gotten in contact with Michael, who was gonna go in and record a song we're not playing today called The List, and needed some musicians, and he reached out.
So it was a studio gig to begin with,
yeah.
And it worked out.
Yeah, we went in, got paid to record, which is always fun, and then we decided Michael was too good to let go, and so we just... grabbed on as hard as we
one
could.
One of us. So the Tourists, though, why?
Because of Text Predictor, we could not come up with a band name ever for the life of us.
That kills some bands before they ever even get off the ground. Yeah. They cannot agree on a name, and they just go, I give up. I give up. So Tourists it was.
It was about a million things before it was Tourists. One day
give us some of the failures.
The 135s, which I thought was pretty great. The 1612s. The Balcony Santas, don't ask. I don't know, a lot of different things. A whole mess of really bad names. And then I just was sick of it, and so in my spare time, I would just start typing on my phone, Michael Barrow and the, and then just pick a letter and see what the next word my phone would predict was. And one day I clicked on T, and it was Tourists. And I sent it to the band chat, and everybody thought it was okay. And then somebody made a graphic for it, and it's our hiker guy that we use now. And it just stuck. It just worked. And so
what about the creative process? Is it just Michael, or is everybody pitching in on the heavy lifting of songwriting?
Especially Juneau, it was mostly Michael. Michael had a lot of stuff that he had been working on. And we just kind of came in and filled out the sound. Since then, it's become a little more collaborative. It's a lot of Michael still, obviously. But yeah, I mean, we'll play a song today called Clover that we wrote in a cabin together.
So you feel you have a voice?
Yeah, through my bass. But yeah, for sure.
But have you written any songs that it's like, this is mine?
No. I'm the bassist. They just put me in the back in the shadows, and I'm really confused that they gave me a mic today, actually, but it works out, I guess.
Well, I think you passed with flying colors. Alessandro, write some songs.
Okay.
Get them in the mix.
I will try.
Right? Okay, let's hear three more songs. Thanks, Alessandro. 12 Bar, Something's New, and All I See Is You. We're listening to Michael Barrow and the Tourists on Highway 89.
Get over me, she said, and now my heart is dead. Oh, it's in pieces on the floor. No sense in beating anymore. You took me like a storm, and all this time I thought that I was born to love you. Well, I'm not so certain anymore. So tell me, what am I supposed to do when there's no such thing as getting over you? The most perfect thing that my two hands have ever held is you. Now I don't know what to do, yeah. No, I couldn't even fight, when the only thing that I've done right in my whole life is tell you that I love you, baby. But now I guess that's through. So tell me, all before, but it's different this time. 'Cause I could listen to your disapproval on repeat when I'm supposed to be trying to make the most of me. Instead of stumbling through the door and falling down on the floor at your feet. But for you, I wanna be something new. I said for you, I wanna be something new. So take the pieces of my broken heart and make yourself a work of art, and let me be something new for you. It's always been this way. Don't know what I can do when my head and my heart are both playing different games. But from the moment I look across the room, saw you smiling back at me, and I swear that I knew then that nothing would ever be the same. Because for you, I wanna be something new. I said for you, I wanna be something new. So take the pieces of my broken heart and make yourself a work of art, and let me be something new for you. You told me there were always blue skies coming. Well, I tried and failed to make it through the gray. And I've never been more tired, but I'll keep running. 'Cause I've been told tomorrow brings another day. There's a whisper on the wind that keeps me going. It promises to lead the way back home. And I hope to God above that it keeps blowing. 'Cause I don't know if I can make it on my own. And oh, the fire burns and then it dies. But the embers draw me back to what I knew. And if we look back when we die at the life we left behind, I know, my dear, that all I'll see is you. There's a stranger staring at me from the mirror. He's foreign and familiar all the same. And with each passing hour, it gets clearer that soon there will be no one left to blame. And oh, the fire burns and then it dies, but the embers draw me back to what I knew. And if we look back when we die at the life we left behind, I know, my dear, that all I'll see is you. Cause love will take your whole life if you let it, and it'll lead you straight to heaven or to hell. But I think we give the devil too much credit for everything we're doing to ourselves. And oh, the fire burns and then it dies, but the embers draw me back to what I knew. And if we look back when we die at the life we left behind, I know, my dear, that all I'll see is you.
All I'll See Is You. Before that, Something New and 12 Bar. You're enjoying Michael Barrow and the Tourists on Highway 89, and now we're welcoming to the interview Mike Zach Collier, the keyboardist, who was going to town on Something New. And so have keys, will travel, right? Your fingers limber? You feeling good?
Yeah, it's good that I've played a lot of video games. You know, my fingers are very, very agile.
Those are worth
something.
Let me
tell you, I mean, it's a lot harder to get girls when you're carrying around a keyboard than it is having a guitar in your backpack.
Why is that?
I think it's just the sheer weight of the instrument. I don't know. I think it's... somehow I managed to get my wife, but... because of the piano.
You guys are working on a new album. Where are you in the process?
So we've got a 5-song EP coming out in, I guess, October, November this year. And then we're
still in the studio?
Yeah. So we actually just recorded 12 Bar and What Is It For? And Something New. So those will all be on the new album. And then we're going to have a full-length album that comes out sometime next year. So right now we're just contacting producers and... yeah.
Now, I hear that this new album is, or the EP is, a shift of style.
Yeah.
You're going from what to what?
So, Juneau was largely.
And is it a sellout?
I mean, well, it depends on if you consider Michael rapping on every track a sellout or not.
Ooh.
He's like, why you got to do that? No, it's not a sellout. I mean, I would say, you know, we're transitioning more from like a roomy, cozy, like lazy Sunday morning folk sound to just more up-tempo blues rock with some folk influences. So
a lot of that's what the kids are listening to these days. You
no.
got to give the kids what they're listening to.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, people have responded pretty well to, you know, to like Sweet Honey and 12 Bar and stuff at shows. It's actually been pretty surprising. And I don't know, it's just fun when you create some music for your enjoyment, and it happens to have some entertainment appeal to other people that you're playing it for.
So that's the problem, the divide between this is the music that's in my heart, this is what's in my marrow, and I must express my muse on the one hand, and then there's the here's what sells, this is what the kids are listening to. How do you jive those two together?
I don't know.
Does it have to be an either or?
I don't think it has to be an either or. I mean, I guess the short answer is we'll let you know when we figure it out. But long answer, I don't know. I think thanks to the internet's kind of killed genre, right, and killed time. So you've got...
By just having too many? There's just too many genres that we can't keep track of.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of the influences that that we've had, you know, are people who are doing you know, throwback sounds, you know, throwback to, I don't know, Blue Eyed Soul and funk and stuff like that, and you know, and we're their niche, you know, their target audience, you know, they've inspired us, so hopefully we can do that for other people. But yeah, the internet music is really interesting because you get you know, all time periods, all, you know, all different styles and stuff mixed together in a blender, and it's kind of a cool, exciting exciting time. It's the Wild West of
that allows
music,
for more freedom than you think.
Yeah,
anything goes.
Yeah, well, I don't know, polka hasn't come back, but so maybe not anything.
Oh,
but,
man,
yeah,
I wish I would. Yodeling, Michael, can you yodel? Work on that. That could be the next big thing. Find your niche. So the Provo music scene has had a lot of success in these past few years. Are you guys next? Is it your turn to hit big?
I think we've got some friends that may hit first before us. Shout out to Cinders. We love you. Yeah, I don't know. Hopefully, I mean, we've been touring a lot. I mean, this year, by the end of the year, we'll have been to 8 different states, which is cool.
What does it take to break through that ceiling?
Ooh, man. I'd like to, I mean, the band's heard me rant about this forever. I'm like the marketing guy, but there's a lot more in common nowadays with musicians. I don't know, you can't compare us to like selling tables or, I don't know, selling burgers or, you know, a physical product. There's a lot more in common with like freemium apps, right, where you've got to hit maximum market penetration and saturation before you can really have an impact. And so it just depends on how long we're willing to stay consistent and how long we're willing to go and how many people we're willing to reach before we can... I don't know.
Blow up.
Yeah, blow up. And yeah, because people don't blow up overnight. I mean, a lot of people are viral sensations, right? And they've got a YouTube video and they show up on Ellen and then nothing comes from them after that. So it's the viral hit is the modern.
It's a fickle listening public.
Yeah.
They can't be trusted.
Oh, I don't know.
You decide what they should be listening to. You tell them what they should be listening to.
Listen to us.
And they should be listening to these two last songs. Let's, the final couple of songs on the show. What are we going to do? And Clover. This is Michael Barrow and the Tourists on Highway 89.
Tell you all that I'm supposed to, so I just keep my mouth shut. Then you fold your arms and tell me that you can't stand when I don't open up. So I stop vocalizing and you start criticizing, and we've gone too far. And girl, I hate the way we are. But what are we gonna do? What are we gonna do? Say it should be easy, let you see the real me. But you don't understand that when I'm talking to you, you leave me feeling confused. And baby, I can't stand it. We keep talking past each other and we gotta find another way to stop this fight. Oh, I don't know if we will make it through the night. But what are we gonna do? What are we gonna do? Thank you. gonna do? Afraid I won't get hurt this time. I've grown used to being on my own. When loneliness is fine, and heartbreak starts to feel like home. Feel you moving in. I'm afraid I won't get hurt this time. I've been letting you inside my head. It's nothing that we thought we'd need. No curtain calls or silver screens, but could it be we're better off this way instead?
Clover. Before that, we heard What Are We Gonna Do?, the final two songs on this installment of Highway 89. It's been our pleasure to have Michael Barrow and the Tourists here with us on today's episode of Highway 89, live in Studio 6. Grateful to Michael Barrow, vocals, lead vocals and the guitar, Alessandro Improta is a bassist, Reed Perkins drums, Mark Lanham, lead guitar and backing vocals, and Zach Collier, keyboards, were joining us today. If you want to see the band in action, check out clips of the show on YouTube at youtube.com/BYU Radio. Highway 89 is a production of BYU Broadcasting in Provo, Utah. I'm Mark Waite, producer and engineer, with assistant producer Christina Jorgensen. Thanks for listening.